The Government of Canada, through the Canadian Northern Economic Development Agency, or CanNor, has recently invested over $3.2 million to support six fisheries projects in Nunavut. This investment is supporting the Nunavut Fisheries Association in their efforts to keep employees safe during COVID by providing PPE and ensuring other health and safety measures are in place. CanNor's investments has also allowed them to continue working with you to support fisheries research throughout Nunavut. This includes supporting small-scale inshore fisheries in Arviat, in Kinngate, and Sanikiluak, along with a test fishery in Frobisher Bay. Offshore, the fund supported your work to examine the potential of redfish in Baffin Bay and Davis Strait. Our funding isn't only about supporting the examination of potential fisheries, it's also about helping you do more with what you catch. That's why we are supporting a test for an omega-3 extraction process in ringed seals. As we emerge from the pandemic, we know it's important to continue to support businesses. That's why CanNor is supporting the Nunavut Fisheries Association's efforts to improve and expand market outreach in Europe and in Asia for the shrimp they catch. We're also working with the government of Nunavut to improve market access and awareness for sealing products. The result of this $3.2 million investment is the creation of dozens of new jobs with the potential to create many, many more.
As the minister responsible for the fisheries and sealing section of our government, which advocates for more fisheries and more sealing, this is a good step forward, and I applaud the federal government for investing, especially CanNor, which has been a steady funder for Nunavut, and something that I have always appreciated for doing this. It is vital that the fisheries section needs to grow, and having roundtable with the very appropriate people around this table, I'm excited to be a participant in this. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everyone. I'm very pleased to be a part of this roundtable today. It's a bright and sunny day here in Iqaluit, and this news of investments into our fisheries development, I think, is welcome. It just makes it a little bit brighter. I know that when I was looking through the different six investment areas, some of the keywords that came out were in terms of research, in terms of exploratory, determination, jobs. And I think when you look through that, it reminds us how important it is that we spend some time developing the fisheries industry in Nunavut. And it gives us hope about the potential job opportunities, which I know is something that I continue to advocate for, Minister Vandal. And you know, ultimately, it's about giving Inuit choices. The diversification of our economy will allow Inuit to choose to have a career in the fisheries industry and more opportunities to do that. Inuit have always been and continue to be innovative and resourceful, and Inuit want to be able to contribute in a positive way to Canadian economy.
So although the announcement is great news in terms of the 3.2 million that's being announced today, the scale and the true vision that's outlined in the Nunavut Agreement is something we all continue to strive for as Inuit, to diversify our economies. And these investments that are being announced today truly provide an opportunity for us all to make strong foundational building blocks. But there's more in terms of the true vision that was outlined in the Nunavut Agreement. And along with the government of Nunavut and Nunavutungavik, we've really cleared a roadmap in terms of what's possible and what the expectations are.
We've been a big supporter of CanNor, and CanNor has done, has been the best thing that's happened from the point of view of fisheries research and development in Inuit. If you look behind me, this is a clear example of a prior funding made possible by CanNor and NICFI as well. This is the latest vessel, Inuit owned and operated, that'll do nothing but inshore research in Nunavut, a vessel called Ludi Pudlu. And she'll be sailing up into Nunavut in July, and we hope that this is the first of many boats to carry out the research that's needed.
One of QIA's listed goals and solutions to food insecurity talks about that every Inuk in the Whikatani region needs to have stable and long-term access to locally harvested country food. So it's because of this that we believe it is vital to have funding toward harvesting country food and have that funding increase. QC has partnered with local hunters and trappers associations to purchase ring seal blubber. So these ring seals would be harvested in Nunavut around the Whikatani region. This blubber will be converted to oil, and the omega-3s found in the oil would be used in healthcare products. The remainder of the meat, as well as the pelts, will stay in the community to increase food security and improve clothing and art opportunities for the pelts as well. This project could provide a long-term and economically viable market for ring seal blubber harvested in Nunavut while also supporting country food harvests.
Thanks for giving me a few minutes here to talk about the funding we're receiving here at WWF that we're very excited about. To support the projects that we're working on with the Hunters and Trappers Associations in Kingite and Senekiluaq, and also with the HTO in Arviat. WWF, being Canada's largest international conservation organization, it may look a bit odd for us to be on a call about fisheries in Nunavut, but we are committed to working towards a future where nature and people thrive, and certainly no one understands the close connection between thriving people and thriving nature more than Nunavummiut.
So having funding like this gives us the opportunity to work with communities, to work with stakeholders, to offer them the programs, offer them the training, and offer them the supports they need to develop their fisheries.
I think that by making these investments today as a government, we're in a position to help Nunavut towards a recovery from the very, very difficult year that we've all had. We're also contributing towards our commitment of creating 1 million jobs across Canada, restoring employment to previous levels. So I'm glad we were able to do this.